Teasel's Tudor Trivia!
Hi, happy Halloween. Now, this Halloween is Teasel's first Halloween with us, and she's been asking me if I know any Tudor ghost stories. So we're here in our pyjamas, and I'm going to share with you and with Teasel the story of the ghost of Thomas Boleyn. Now, you're going to listen rather than looking out for cats, Teasel. She's not sure. Now, for those of you who don't know, Thomas Boleyn was the father of Queen Anne Boleyn and the grandfather of Queen Elizabeth I. In May 1536, Teasel, he lost two of his children, Queen Anne and George Boleyn, Lord Rochford, after they were executed for treason against King Henry VIII. Poor Thomas even had to sit on the commission judging four of the men brought down with them, and he had to find them guilty, which of course prejudiced his daughter's trial. It must have been something that haunted him until his death in March 1539. And perhaps this is something, him having to do that and him not being able to save his children, that has made him restless in the afterlife. Because every year, and apparently for a term of 1,000 years, Thomas's ghost has to drive a ghostly coach and horses over 12 bridges on a route which takes him from Blickling Hall in Norfolk to Elsham, Borough, Buxton, Coltishall, Mayton, Oxnead and Wroxham. He has to cross all 12 bridges before cockcrow on the 19th of May, the anniversary of his daughter's execution. Now, I'm not actually sure what happens if he doesn't make it, if he doesn't manage to do all 12 bridges, but he has to keep doing this for 1,000 years. The present Blickling Hall is Jacobean, but the Boleyn family home stood there in the Tudor period and may well have been the birthplace of Anne Boleyn. The family later moved to Hever Castle in Kent. Now, Teasel, Thomas Boleyn's ghost is not the only Boleyn ghost linked to Blickling. A headless Anne Boleyn is also said to return to the hall on the 19th of May every year, being brought in a coach drawn by headless horsemen and bearing her head in her lap. When the coach draws up to Blickling, it then disappears, thankfully. So, there's some ghost stories for you. Did I scare you, Teasel? Are you going to be able to sleep? What do you think? So there you go. I thought I'd just share those ghost stories with you for Halloween. I know they don't actually happen on Halloween. They're more to do with the 19th of May, but they're ghost stories. Anyway, I hope you have a wonderful Hallowtide. We'll see you soon, won't we, Teasel? Say bye-bye. Yeah, bye-bye. She's very tired. She wants to go to bed. See you soon. Take care.
Teasel's Tudor Trivia.